Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. Welcome back to another Shopify tutorial video. And in this video, I'll walk you through how you can add a stylish product page slider to your Shopify Dawn theme. And it's gonna work on latest version. So I created a video before that and it was working fine, but I'm receiving a lot of comments on that video that it's no longer working. So I thought to create an updated version of that. After following this tutorial, you will have the Shopify product page slider, which will look like this. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you want me to add more value to my content and provide you guys with more free tutorials. So without further ado, let's jump into the screen.
Okay guys, so that's how your product page will look like, with a cool sliding slider. So click on these arrows and the product images will be changed. You can also drag it to left or right. Similarly with the product thumbnail images, you can simply scroll it and also click to change the image. Cool, right? That's how the desktop version looks like. And now check out the mobile version. That's how the mobile version will look like. Click on it to change the image. Perfect. Okay. And that's how the original version looks like. So if you want to learn how to implement this, stick to the video. I'll walk you through step by step on how you can do that. That's the tutorial which I'll be following. I'll put the link in the video description so you guys can easily copy and paste the codes. So you don't need to pay anything. You don't need to add in any app for that. You can simply copy and paste the code and implement the functionality of product slider. I already created a video on this, but few of you guys commented out that menu is not working after implementing this tutorial. So I just want to show you guys that it's working fine. Here it is. Let's check it out on the mobile version as well. Cool, everything is working fine. Yep, everything seems to be working fine. Okay, so that's the backend of my Shopify store. First, click on online store, and I'm going to add a latest version of Dawn theme. That's the Dawn theme 10.0, where I've already added all of the codes to show you guys how it's gonna look. And I'm going to add a latest version right now. So click on add button and my latest Dawn theme 10.0.0 is being installed on my development store. Okay, it's installed now. Now click on publish. And that's a fresh theme which is published. Now let's preview it. Preview the same product page here. So, that's the product page. You can see that that's how it looks. Now we will start adding the codes. I'm going to close out these old tabs here and just open up this product and our tutorial, which we'll be following. Now let's go back to themes. And from these three small dots, click on edit code before editing the code. If you're working on a live version, make sure to have a duplicate of your theme. So in case you mess up anything, you can easily revert it back. Okay, click on edit code. And now first step is to create this asset file. Now in order to do so, I'll scroll down here, click on assets folder, and then from here I'll click on add a new asset and then click on create a blank file, and I'll type flickity and then click on done. Go back to the code instruction, click on copy code. So just click on this copy code button, all of the CSS code will be copied to your clipboard. And you can simply paste it. There you go. And now click save. Now, another asset which we need to create is a JS file. Click on this add a new asset button. Click on create a blank file. Scroll down to JS. Name it Flickity again, but that's a JS asset, not a CSS asset. So make sure to select JS from this dropdown. Now click on done. And then go back to the tutorial. Here's my JS file. So just click on this copy code button and the code will be copied to your clipboard. Go back to your theme and paste the code. Okay, after pasting the code, it's safe. Go back to the instructional tutorial and that's the code which we will be adding in our theme.liquid file. So copy code, go back to theme file editor, search for theme.liquid file. And this code will be pasted under head. So just paste the code here, click save. Go back to the tutorial again. And that's the complete main-product.liquid file. So I had to change a lot of CSS classes and add in and created a lot of new divs. So I just gave you guys the complete main-product.liquid file. So you can simply copy and paste and replace it with your main-product.liquid file. So copy the code and go back to your theme file editor, search for main-product.liquid file and just replace it completely. So delete all of the code which is currently in this file and copy it, copy the new code from here and paste it to your main-product.liquid file. After doing it, click on save. And then the next step is to copy the global.js file. And as you can see, I have already mentioned that if you are on a latest version, which is Dawn 10.0.0, you can skip this step. You have to skip this step, right? This is only for Dawn 6.0.2 and below. Hopefully I'm gonna remove this soon because I don't think anyone have Dawn 6.0.2 version anymore. So just skip the global.js step and move on to the base.css step. Click on copy code and search for base.css file. So if you guys are implementing this tutorial on any of the theme, and if you are not finding base.css file, you can add in the CSS code to any of your theme CSS file. It does not have to be base.css. You can add in this code to any of the CSS file. And this code should work completely fine on all of the free themes. So for example, Studio Block, Taste, Sense, all of these free themes have quite similar code base. So it should work fine completely with all of the free themes of Shopify. Okay, now in this step, we'll just copy this code and paste it to the bottom of base.css file. So scroll down to the bottom and paste the code. And after pasting the code, it's safe. Okay, now let's refresh our product page to see how it looks. Okay, looks great. Looks perfectly fine. And check out the thumbnail images. Yep, it works great. And now check out the mobile version. Yep, looks great. Check out the menu, because again, I have received a lot of comments in my old video that the menu was not working after we added the product slider, because I already had the video for adding product slider. But as you can see, it's working completely fine on the mobile version. And that's the second, that's another product where we have multiple images. So cool, it's working completely fine. That's it for the tutorial, guys. If you want more such tutorials, don't forget to comment on the video below and let me know what more tutorials you would like me to create for you guys. Until next video, have a great day.